Thanks for calling King of Wing. How may I help you?
Yes, can I speak to the king, please?
Yes, ma'am. Hold, please.
May I help you?
Yes, I would like to have one of those big old burgers I seen advertised on TV.
Oh, you want the big double meat? That's a big burger, baby. Think you can handle all that?
King of Wing burger so good to make me want to shake it.
Shake it, baby. Shake that booty down for me.
Shake that booty down for me.
Do the dingo. Shake.
I love cheese and potatoes. It's ooey gooey and just yum, yum, yummy.
Miss Brian, I hate pickles. I hate everything about them. Pickles are destroying my life. People make fun of me. I feel ashamed and I'm actually afraid of them. When I think about pickles, I just want to throw up and run away. What I hate most about the pickles is the shape, the texture of it, the color, the
In a world held hostage by hunger, they turn to one of the toughest men who ever lived, Russell Salvatore. The Steak Man. His mission, to deliver the finest cuts of beef.
Here's a ribeye for you. Here's a strip steak for you. Nothing but prime beef and Russell's steaks, chops, and more.
Top cut.
Be my guest and let us do the rest.
Take a bite of my hot dog.
Fresh as the morning sunrise, as great as the break of dawn. We've baked the bread so it's ready as you put the kettle on.
Here on location, you can see behind me, alien ships have appeared over Barbados. We don't know where they came from. We don't know what they want, but it might be the end of the world as we know it.
Wait, they killed all the Zephyrus bread?
What do you think of the aliens taking on all the Zephyrus bread?
You can't really blame them. Zaffron's bread is out of this world.
Zaffron's Bakeries, as fresh as the morning sunrise.
When I eat cheesy potatoes, I mean, it instantly puts a smile on my face.
This is Weber Cooks, and today we're doing a dish using potatoes and cream style corn. We take some of the potatoes, we pop them in the microwave, and we set the microwave for 10 minutes. And while that's cooking, we'll take the cream style corn and we'll open that up. And this will actually go on the potatoes after I mash them. Okay, the potatoes are done. We just pop them out of the microwave and we open them up and mash them.
Why won't you call me? Steven, why won't you call me?
And then we just pour the cream style corn on it and we put it back in the microwave for another 3 minutes, and when it's done, and there you have it, a potato dish that costs about $1. And I'm Stephen Reed, and this is Weber Cooks.
Oh, God, it's so good.
So good. So good and tasty.
Hi, I'm Chef Mike Nyland. I'm a Tucson personal chef, I'm here to show you how to make a three cheese blend for pizza. First you start with shredded mozzarella, then a shredded provolone, and then a freshly grated Parmesan. You mix them all together in the bowl. And then you can use it for your favorite pizza. That's how you make a three cheese blend for your pizza.
Okay. Stop. Stop shaking. And you're a waitress?
Yeah.
In a restaurant? Aren't there pickles around?
Yeah, but I'm nowhere near them.
You're nowhere near them?
No, I'm not, no.
What happens if somebody wants a pickle?
That's too bad.
I kantina på Elvebakken har vi bredt utvalg av mat og drikke. For uten mat og drikke duger ikke helten. Vi har billige bagetter, jus på kartong, ja, og masse, masse mer. På fredager det taco-baguett? Taco-baguett? Ta en tur innom da vel.
This Sussex County restaurant is the only place in the state still serving this Delaware delicacy.
Folks from all over the place, come and get that rat.
Every Wednesday during muskrat season, the dining room fills with hearty fans looking to get their muskrat fix.
Wednesday night, the phone's ringing. It's ringing all week long. Muskrat, are you having muskrat? People pile in here and have good conversation and good muskrat.
Experienced eaters like Milford's Chuck Coverdale order their muskrat with the heads on.
I got two extra heads because basically a lot of people come in, they say we don't want the head on it. That's the best part of it right there. The jaws and the brain, that's the best part. And all you have to do to get the brain out of it. And there it is, right there. Right there. It's a little tiny, it looks like a little almond is what it looks like. That's the brain.
The family thinks always from morning to evening about the potatoes. I dream of potatoes.
All this food is for a gift of $2,500. 8 years of bulk food. This is what you should be doing.
Wow.
John, you come up here. You're the rice preacher. You told me to do this. They got shovels. By the way, get a shovel. These are foldable shovels. It'll go in your backpack. This is how you dig the latrine. We made up. They've been cooking during the show.
Wow.
And this rice is hot. Woo, just me.
Yes, it just came out.
I am the genie of the bottle. I will grant you three wishes. Wish number one.
I'd like the finest steakhouse menu in all of Western New York.
Wish number two.
I'd love a beautiful jacuzzi suite.
Wish number three.
A friend?
As you wish.
Not what I had in mind.
Be my guest and let us do the rest.
Hi, my name is Chef Mike Nyland. I'm a Tucson personal chef, and I'm here to show you how to store pizza dough properly in the refrigerator. After you shape your dough, and you're not going to use it for that day, wrap it tightly in saran wrap and store in the refrigerator in the coldest part on the top shelf. If you aren't going to use it within 2 or 3 days, store it in the freezer and thaw out the day before you need it. And that is how you properly store pizza dough in the refrigerator.
I can't.
Come here, baby.
It's okay.
Well, I like chicken. Chicken is finger licking. I like ham. I like ham. Hot damn. I like pork. guess people do from New York, like pork.
Music is brain food, and there's nothing like home cooking.
Bruce's Liquors, we've got the bargains for you. Woo, woo, woo. Crazy Bruce's Liquors, selection and quality too. Woo, woo, woo. Come down and see us, you'll think we're too good to be true. Woo, woo, woo. Zinfandel and Cabernet, Red Merlot and Chardonnay, Crazy Bruce's Liquor Store. Woo, woo.
What's up, everybody? This is JC. I'm here to give you some tips on my cheese and macaroni. So I'm going to show you the way I do it, and the reason why I titled the show Cooking with the Skinny Dude with a Pot Belly. Eating stuff like this gave me the pot belly. Okay, now we're going to let the noodles boil for around 7 minutes. Make sure you stir. And for the cheese. I don't know how much cheese I put in here, but I keep mixing it until it's ready. And not only do I put cheese here in the macaroni, I also put cheese in my secret sauce. I make this secret sauce to make sure cheese goes everywhere. Okay, after you finish mixing the cheese, mix in more cheese. Mixing in that cheese, guess what? More cheese. I like the mozzarella. Makes it stringy. So, we're gonna mix that on in there. Right, nice. So we guaranteeing cheese is going to be in every square inch. I'm going to save a little bit. Make sure it don't. Okay, I'm just going to pour in the rest of the secret sauce. It's just going to seep on down in there. And I just sprinkle cheese on the top for a good look. There you go. Nice and pretty. Every noodle got cheese on it. And it's ready for the oven. All right, before you put it in the oven, I'll bake it with a lid. Keeps it from burning. I spray it with the nonstick. So when you pull out the oven, just pull the lid off and the cheese don't get stuck to the top of it.
It's like about 50 pounds of mac and cheese and mac.
Wiener time.
That's all. I've told my story, and I'll stand tall.
Oh, this is ragu. Oh, I'm in heaven. This is ragu.
I don't want to touch a forest.
fries on these homemade dishes and chocolatey desserts, all made with ramen noodles.
Really? Ramen noodles?
Yes, ramen. Hi, Kathy Mitchell here with my new Ramen Joy cookbook, filled with unbelievable recipes everyone will love. This entire basket cost under $10, and wait till you see what you can make with it. Check these out. Ramen shrimp, ramen tacos, even ramen sliders. Watch this. Brown some beef or any other meat with a ramen seasoning pack. Dump in a package of ramen, a good-sized squirt of ketchup, and a can of cola. Yes, cola. For a fantastic barbecue beef pasta better than what they serve at the rib joint at a fraction of the cost. Want more? Form cooked ramen and egg into a fast pizza crust. Then add your favorite toppings for a mouth-watering pizza in minutes. It's right here on page 84. And here's my favorite. Just dump some ramen on top of some leftover chicken and veggies. Add a can of soup, stir and bake. A delicious feast for the whole family, all for less than $3. Want the best salad ever? Start with lettuce, onions, and mandarin oranges. Top with crushed ramen and pecans, and use your seasoning pack to make an awesome dressing. A restaurant bestseller you can easily make at home. Ooh, love that crunch. How about these decadent truffles or grandma's ramen apple pie? Mm-mm.
I love these recipes. I made the creamy berry crumble. It was fast, easy, and so delicious.
Ooh. I was at the Italian Ice King enjoying a can of soda and Chuckles fat-free candy. I had no idea that a little devil was making his way into my soft drink.
I have potato blood in my veins. My life, it's potato.
What did you do at school?
Well, today Miss Mayhew gave us candy.
Candy?
Oh, it's okay.
Candy at school? Why'd you get candy at school?
I don't know.
Candy? Bless this family, in Jesus' name, amen.
Candy! Ladies and gentlemen, the nominees for Best Actor in a Dramatic Performance are Russell Salvatore in The Chairman, Russell Salvatore in Top Cut, Russell Salvatore in Die Hard. And the award goes to Russell Salvatore, of course.
This is the 84th win and third nomination for Russell J. Salvatore.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I want to thank the Steak Academy, my agent, for this great presentation. No, John, I'm not done yet. Be my guest and let us do the rest.
In there. Boy, look at the steam come out of it. Wow. Okay, look at this. Look at this. Boy, what I love... put my hands in there, but it's hot. This is
the cheesy broccoli rice.
Look at the broccoli in there.
Oh. Wow.
Look at the broccoli.
That's good.
Why wouldn't you want that on the top of a pizza? If I went gross
this
you
would
out,
meet everyone.
I would eat right out of this shovel.
Wow.
Let's dump this in with the rice. There it goes. We're dumping 22 gallons into the rice. There it goes.
Wow.
Into the rice. Now I have 44 gallons. What if you have to survive for 2 years or 3 years? You're gonna need some more food. But, oh my.
I have cheese all over my mouth, I'm sure. I need a napkin.
And
you're doing, you know, girls need napkins.
You put real broccoli in here, right?
There's 100% real broccoli.
That's a good dog. What?
But with the safety lid lifter lids, you put them in the trash. I can't make it cut through the bag. That's the beautiful part about this. There's so many dimensions to liking the safety lid lifter. Hello, Joe. How you doing today?
Hello, Bob.
Welcome to the show.
Oh, well, thank you. It is an honor to speak with you, and I do have the lid lifter.
Uh-huh.
It is a fantastic device, and one time I've got to say we've got some rat problems here in where I live, and they went on the top of the can, and I opened it with my old one, and it went into the food.
Now, see, you got right there, whatever the mouse was stepping in just went into your food.
Yeah, and some bacteria, and, you know, I didn't give it to the kids, but then that, I said, when that happened, I said, that's it. That's the last straw.
That's the last one,
I'm getting the lid lifter.
Hello, and welcome to Henry's Kitchen, where today we're going to be making Henry's tuna fried rice. Borrowing cuisines from other cultures or cultural appropriation is a very sensitive issue, and I want to make it very clear that with this dish, I'm going to be as historically accurate as possible, and that today is a celebration, not an exploitation of fried rice. Oh, and this is Archie. He got his tooth fixed, but they gave him this haircut, which is really just kind of stupid. So, I don't know. I haven't really been taking him outside just because, you know, it's kind of embarrassing to be out with him. But I'm just waiting for it to grow out a little bit. Okay, we're going to start by scrambling up one egg. These eggs are actually pre-cracked, but you can use any kind you want. It's going to cook pretty quick, maybe about a minute or two, so let's go ahead and put it aside. We're going to pour some oil in the pan. And we're going to put in some of our rice. You actually want to make the rice the day before and use the leftovers. It's a better texture. Actually, this rice is quite a few days older than that, so that's good. I'm going to add some canned veggies. A little bit of salt. Little pepper, add some soy sauce. You know, I used to have this girlfriend who had a dog, and every time I went over there, the dog would start humping my leg. And I was always told that the best thing to do when you're in that situation is to just go with it, you know? This is no time to be a hero. Now we're gonna add in some of our meat. And you can actually use any kind of meat that you have. And finally, let's go ahead and add our egg. Okay, we're gonna stir our fried rice for about 3 minutes, and when we're done, we're gonna have fried rice. Oh, and since everybody's requesting this, I'm doing another run of my Henry's Kitchen signature aprons, so if you'd like to get an apron, you can read about that in the description area. Let's make fried rice.
Help me make it through the night, 'cause I am tired and alone. I don't like myself anymore.
Your dog's face looks like a mop.
I guess I'm just not interesting. I have no personality.
And that's how you make Henry's tuna fried rice. Thanks, everyone. And if you'd like to know when I'm going to be in your neighborhood, you can just click on the link below.